Hey everyone, Scott here, and can you believe it's been 2 years since I first uploaded a video on Amazon attribution? It's actually one of the first videos I ever uploaded on my channel and still a popular one right now. So I thought it'd be a good idea to do an updated training since there's been some changes since my last video. You can even get some money back from Amazon from sales you generate using Amazon attribution, which I'll also cover in this video. Plus I have a couple more years of experience using Amazon attribution. So this video will have everything you need to know about how to use it. Plus I'll share some of the best practices I've learned along the way. If you find value in this, I truly appreciate it if you help me out by hitting the like button. And let's go ahead and get right into it. So first we should go over, what is Amazon attribution? Amazon attribution is a tool developed by Amazon that tracks sales that come from external traffic. So places like Facebook ads, Instagram, you know, Pinterest, TikTok, Google ads, or any of the other platforms out there. And it doesn't have to be paid advertising. It could be free or organic traffic as well. So for example, if you want to track how many sales come from an email that you send to an email list, or maybe you have a blog that is directing to your Amazon listing, you want to track how many sales are coming from that blog, or maybe you have an influencer you're working with, you want to see how many sales that influencer is generating, you can use Amazon attribution for all of that. Now, Amazon attribution is a URL-based tracking method. So what that means is the tracking is done by adding a tag to your standard URL. And then when someone clicks on it, Amazon tracks what happens after that. They track, you know, things like Amazon listing views, they track add to carts, they track sales, and a lot of other metrics as well. So that's different than a lot of other ad platforms that maybe use pixels like Facebook ads or cookies to do the tracking. And that's because Amazon doesn't allow sellers to place cookies or pixels onto the Amazon website, at least at this point in time. And really, I don't see them ever allowing it. So they're using the URL method. So right here, I have a normal URL. This is a standard Amazon listing URL, also called the canonical URL. This will take you directly to the Amazon listing. And this is what it looks like once you've generated an attribution tag from that URL. I highlighted in the orange part, the actual tag part that's added to the end of the URL. Now, if you click on either one of these links, you'll end up in the exact same place and it will look exactly the same. There's really no difference to the person that's clicking on it. The only difference is that the URL that you'll see up in the browser is a little bit different. So the first step before getting into creating the tags is to determine what you're tracking. This will make things a lot easier when you go to create the tags. So for example, are you tracking just one product with that tag? Are you going to be tracking a group of products? Are you going to be tracking all of your products? So once you decide that, you also want to decide, how detailed do you want to be? So using Facebook ads as an example, you could track all the sales coming from Facebook using one single Amazon attribution tag. That means that no matter what ad generated the sale, it'd still be tracked through that link. The downside to that though, is you can't tell which individual ad is actually creating the sale for you. Another way you could do it is you could use a separate tag for every single ad that you have. The upside to that is that you'll be able to tell which ad is creating the sale for you on Amazon. So the ones that are working, keep going. And the ones that aren't working, you can go ahead and turn off. For me personally, I prefer to be on the more detailed side because of the more detailed tracking you can get. So let's get into creating an Amazon attribution campaign. Now you can find it easily by going to your PPC manager or your campaign manager within your Amazon account. Go over to the left column over here, go to measurement and reporting, click on there and you'll see Amazon attribution right there. So the first thing you want to do is come down here and click create campaign. The next is to choose your creation method. Typically, I'll just do it manually, but if you're using Facebook ads or Google ads, there is a way to create all your tracking links in bulk. So you just come down here, you select whether you're using Facebook ads or Instagram ads or Google ads, and then you go ahead and download the template file here and follow the instructions on the template file. But for this video, I'm going to go ahead and go into creating one manually. The first thing we want to do is name the campaign. So think of the campaign as a holder for all of your attribution tags. I usually like to create the campaign based on a particular type of promotion I'm doing, or maybe a particular product that I'm advertising on a certain ad platform. So in this video, I'm going to use plant protein as an example, or vegan protein. So if I was advertising on, let's say, Facebook, I might do something like this. I might put the name of the product I'm doing, then I'll put the platform, Facebook, and then I'll do the type of promotion I'm doing. So for example, like 15% off. And then personally, I like to put the date as well, so I can just easily see when I created this campaign. You can do any type of naming convention you want. So come up with something that works for you. But once you decide on something, try to keep it consistent. That way it's just easier to look over your campaigns and find the data that you're looking for. You don't have to fill out an external ID if you don't want to. I usually don't. The next step is go down and pick the product or products you're going to advertise. Then the next step is to create the ad group. Now, the way to think about ad groups when it comes to Amazon attribution is each ad group holds one tag. So that might be a little bit different than like Facebook ads, for example, where one ad group can hold a bunch of different ads. And with Amazon attribution, one ad group is one tag. So you want to name it by what you're tracking. So if you are doing a particular ad group, you might name it by that ad group. If you were doing a particular ad, you want to name it somehow to reference that ad. If you were doing Google ads and you wanted to track by individual keywords, you might put keyword and then just name it the keyword that you're tracking. So however you want to do it, you can do that. Publisher is just a way to select where the Amazon attribution tag is going to be used. This isn't super important. So for example, if you selected Google and then you place the attribution tag on Facebook, the tag would still work. It just messes up your reporting. So let's say we're doing Facebook. So you'll just come down here and select Facebook. Now, if you have an ad platform or something that's not in here, you can just go up here to new and select that instead. But I'm going to go down here. I'm going to select Facebook. And then the channel is just what you're doing. So in this case, it's only social because they know Facebook is a social platform. But you can see over here that some of the other options that might pop up are display, email, search. If you select a Google Ads, it'll select search, video. Again, this isn't super important. This is more just for tracking purposes. So in this case, social is the only option. And then you want to get the click-through URL. So the click-through URL is the original URL that you want people to click on. Now, you can either send it, for example, directly to your Amazon listing. You might send it, if you have an Amazon store with a bunch of different products, you could send them to your Amazon store or a particular page of that Amazon store. So once you decide where you want to send them on Amazon, you take that link and you just put it right here. And then for the ad group name, you can just go ahead and use a similar naming convention that you decided to use for the campaign. So for this one, just as an example, I put the product name, plant protein, Facebook, which is where it's going to be. And then I just put video ad one, so I know where this tag is going to be put. And then if you wanted to create this tag, you just go ahead and hit the create button up here. Now, one thing that's handy is that if you had multiple tags you needed to create, an easy way to do that is you can just go down here and click add new ad group, or you can come over here and click on duplicate if you want to just keep some of this info. So I'll just go ahead and do duplicate. And all you need to do now is just rename. Maybe you want to name this one video ad two and put the click-through URL. If it's the same URL, just copy and paste. And you just keep doing that for as many tags as you needed for that particular campaign. So once you hit create, it'll take you to a page with all of your tags that you created. An easy way to do this is to just go ahead and download all your tags into a CSV file, a spreadsheet, so you can just have it and look at it whenever you want to. But you can see here, you see the ad group, the channel, your attribution tag. You can see the original click-through link. So the next thing to do is to go ahead and use these tags while creating your ads. So on Facebook, you would go to the, while you're creating an ad, you'd use this as the URL that you want people to go to once they click on the ad. And you wanna make sure that you're getting the entire attribution tag. So everything from the start to the end. When you're putting it in there, you want to use the entire tag. So once you're using the tags and people are clicking on them and maybe buying, you can come back into this main campaign area and you can see things like the number of click-throughs, the total page views, detail page views, the add to carts, the purchases, total sales, all of that. And then if you want to see some more individual stats, you could go in and click on your individual campaigns and go from there. Now, there is another way to do some more detailed reporting as well. All you have to do is come over here, go to measurements and reporting, and then go to reports right here. And then you click on create report. And then for the report category, click on here and you can see Amazon attribution is a category you can do. So go ahead, click on there. You can do the report type by channel publisher, by campaign, by keyword or creative, all these. You can take a look at what all these mean. And then you can set the time period that you want to do and run the report. And then if you have a report that you want to consistently run, maybe every single month, you can set it up to run every single month automatically for you. And there's a couple things to be aware of. So you should be seeing your clicks within a day. If you're not seeing any clicks and you know you've gotten multiple clicks through the link, go ahead and see if there's any problems with your original click-through link that you use. Make sure that you're using the entire attribution tag, that there's no errors with that. There is going to be a little bit of a discrepancy. Amazon says that typically between 10 to maybe 20% difference between the clicks you see on your ad platform to the clicks that they're reporting. And that's just because there's a difference. I mean, if you've ever used Facebook ads, you know that there's sometimes some difference between the amount of clicks or the amount of orders they say you got compared to, let's say, like Google Analytics or something like that. So there's always going to be a little bit of difference between tracking platforms. There's not going to be 100% accuracy, but it should be close enough. If you're getting, like, you know, way more than 20% clicks than what you should be, you want to make sure that you're not using that link somewhere else that you don't know about that's generating clicks. Just kind of check some different things like that. And then for orders, you want to allow at least a couple days for those to show up. Similar to Amazon PPC, you know that the orders sometimes don't immediately show up. It might take a day or two, maybe even 3 days for that order to show up. And Amazon attribution is a last click attribution model, meaning that the credit is going to go to the tag that got the last click. So if you're using tags for Google ads and for Pinterest ads, and someone sees your Pinterest ad, clicks on it, doesn't buy, and then they see your Google ad, they click on it and buy, the Google ad is going to get the credit. And there is a 14-day look-back window, meaning that from the time that someone clicks on the link, 14 days forward from that point, if they come back and purchase, it will still count in the reporting as coming from the attribution link. So I want to tell you how you can get some money back from Amazon by using Amazon attribution. Come down here to brands and then come down here to the brand referral bonus. So this page will tell you all about the brand referral bonus. You can see here that you can earn about an average of the 10% of the product sales driven from Amazon attribution. And this includes all of your Amazon products. So if someone clicks, finds one product, buys that one plus another one, or they don't buy that product, but another one of your products, if you're brand registered. And again, the key to this as well is that you have to be brand registered to use Amazon attribution, at least as of right now. And you also need to be brand registered to use the brand referral bonus. But no matter what product they buy from you, as long as it's part of your brand, you will get a 10% bonus back. And you can look at all the details here. It's very easy to enroll. All you have to do, I'm already enrolled, so you won't see the exact same button that I have, but there should be an enrollment button here. Just read the terms of service and go ahead and enroll. And then you don't have to do anything else. So if you already have Amazon attribution tags created, you can still use those tags. You don't have to create brand new tags in order to get credit for those sales. But I would say Amazon is just trying to encourage and incentivize more people to send traffic to their website, as opposed to sending that traffic to maybe their own website, like their own Shopify website. So that little 10% bonus does help to incentivize that and helps to offset your advertising costs as well. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions at all, go ahead and leave it down in the comments. I always try to reply to comments. I'll even reply to comments that from videos that are like a year old or 2 years old. If there's a good question on there, I'll try to answer it for you. So if you have any questions, feel free to put it down there. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe if you want to see more content like this, and I'll see you in the next one.